Say hi to your new billing best friend Amperture. So in this video, I will be discussing about other next feature of Amperture, that is sale. But before that, if you haven't seen my previous video regarding first two feature of Amperture, then I will suggest do watch it for full clarity. So let's discuss about sale feature. So when you will click on the sale feature, you will see a first option, that is sale invoice. It means you can generate a bill from this option. So for generating an invoice, you have to click on add sale option. As I'm clicking, then you have to select the names of the parties. If you want to add any new party, you can add from here. After filling all the required details, you have to submit. Your new party will be created. So I'm selecting the existing party for demo purpose. So I have selected existing party. All the details will be already there. You don't have to fill manually. After that, you have to select date of supply. Whatever will the state of supply be, you select from here. Then you have to select the items. Then you have to fill its quantity and its unit, as I'm showing here. Enter the amount, then select the GST percentage as per your need. Now after that, you can add bank details. If you have any other account, you can fill the all required details. Then at last, you have to submit. Your new bank account will be created. So there is both check and cash option. Whatever will be the mode of payment, you just select it. As I'm selecting cash option just for demo purpose, and you can fill the description box if needed. Then just submit. Your sale invoice is ready with all the details you have just filled. And from template section, you can just select the design of your template according to your choice. And from there, you can download it or print it according to your need. Your invoice is ready and it's downloaded in your system. Hey guys, welcome back. So today in this video, I will be discussing about next point of sale, that is quotation. So after clicking on the sale feature, quotation option will appear. And on the right corner, add quotation will appear. You have to just click on the option, select party name, or you can just add new party by filling all the required information and submit it. Your new party will be added. For showing you all, I am selecting existing name. All the details will be added automatically. Now you just have to select the state of supply. After that, you have to select the item, or you can add, as I have told you earlier, about party name. Likewise here, you can add. After fill all the details and submit, your new items will be created. Then fill the quantity, whatever will be the quantity, fill it here and select the unit. Then enter the required amount as I'm entering. Then fill the discount percentage box. After that, you can add new bank if needed with all the details. Then there will be a cash and check option. Select according to the mode of payment. Then after filling every details, click on submit. Your quotation is ready. You can also select the template according to your choice, and you can print or download as per your need. Hello everyone, in this video I will be discussing about next option of sale, that is payment in. So when you will open sale feature, payment in option will be visible. After that, click on add payment in option. Select or add party name as per your requirement. So I'm selecting the existing name. After that, select the invoice date. Then select the payment type option, means cash or check. Then enter the received amount, whatever the amount is, and click on submit option. Your transaction details will be visible on your screen with just one click, and you can download it if you want it. Hey everyone, in this video I will be discussing about next option of sale, that is sale order. From this option, you can manage all your sale order with transaction details. First, click on the sale order option, then click on add sale order. After that, select the party name, or you can add new one. So I'm selecting the existing name. Automatically the details will be filled. Then you have to select the item, or you can add a new item. After that, fill the details, quantity, whatever the quantity is, and select its unit. Then enter the amount, and in this also you can add any new bank details, or you can select the existing one, and you can select the cash or check option as per your need. After that, select the order date and due date, and after filling every details, just submit. Your sale order will be generated. Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video I will be discussing about next and last option of sale, that is sale return. So when you will open sale return option, on the right corner there will be add credit note. So you just have to go to sale invoice, and from there just copy the invoice number on that specific order and paste it on the sale number, as I'm showing you here, and click on search option. Every details will be visible, and then submit it. Your sale return order is ready with every details, and you can select the template according to your choice, as I am showing you here. And lastly, you can download it from download option, and you are ready to go.